Howdy, it's me. Slightly less medicated medic Mark come to you from the bunker system located underneath the Red Philippine somewheres in the jungles of the Midwest. And today I'm coming to you with a stack of records because I got a stack of records. I got a stack. Stacks all over, but I got more records today. Why? Because I was out running about today and I got records. That's why. It's as simple as that. So is there anything else going on? I was like, oh, you got to think of something. Then I realized I hadn't shared this. This is just one of many. It's my wife, the real outsider artist. Not like me. I was real fake. I was real. Looking back on it now, holy smokes. That's right. But my wife is in no training whatsoever. Doesn't know a Michelangelo from a non-Michelangelo. A Kandinsky from a Picasso. In fact, I barely know the difference. She's never sold artwork. She just gives it away. Ah! Oh! Oh, I'm sorry, art world. Oh, whatever you do for a gift, buy art, because artists never, they just, anyway, you know, artists complain about that. They feel like people should be buying their art. She doesn't care. She just gives it away. It's a wonder at work. She's given everybody like two or three pieces of work. I mean, it's just amazing. But I haven't heard any fallout from that. That's mine, by the way. That's it. I picked this one out especially. I have two or three of them in my room. I want this one too. So she's gone through various, just like any artist, you know, she does one thing for a while, then kind of, it's the same thing, but then goes on to another look, and this is the new look. I like it, bright and colorful. And she just makes everything up. I have helped her. She asks me questions, but then she doesn't listen to me. It does what she wants, of course. So she just, the collars and the placements and everything of all the stuff, the little bling. And she finds a photograph she likes, and when she, I call them personality pieces. She's doing them for somebody. She figures out what the person is all about. She finds little things that mean something to the person. She puts them down. Called personality pieces. That's what I call them. Anyway, let's go right to the record. Sorry, I had to stop because I was full of gas. Okay. Well, and I finally found out the cutoff date for the coronavirus is if you're 60 or over, you're going to die. So just be prepared for that. And that's it's a whole strange thing, isn't it? I talk about the coronavirus, leave your thoughts, but it's so there's one group of people that are saying, all these people just die from the regular flu and, it's just like, it's no worse. It's not as worse, and a lot of people aren't going to be affected by it at all. So you just think, well, if it's just like the regular flu, just treat it like that. Let it go. But then the other people are like Italy, where they locked down the whole country, and China's blowing Clorox across the street. The ships are, you can't get off ships, and colleges are closing early. So it just can't all be politics and fear, right? So there's got to be something going on there because it's so contagious. So is the idea just to, which they're not telling you, well, they're not telling you they're going to cure it. They're not. But just to slow it down so people can kind of, everybody doesn't get sick all at once, right? But nonetheless, just the fear of it and all of this, and you're probably getting it too. If you belong to a club or anything that you're associated with, they're sending out their legal notices, which tell you, it's not our fault if you get sick, wash your hands, right? Like at the gym I go to, now on the TV set, it's not a happy person doing exercises. It's this graphic warning about the virus and to wash your hands, right? So what exactly is going on? Why the containment, and because it's so contagious, they just don't want everybody to be sick all at once. But nonetheless, getting sick over a longer period of time is damaging in a way to people's life, work and life and the economy, right? Did I go on too long about that? I probably did. Anyway, that's my question. The question is, I can't remember now. Let's go to the records. Okay. On the top of the stack are some of the Phase 4 records I found a few weeks ago. I probably have this one, but I'm not sure. But I picked it up anyway, because you know all the reasons I talk about each and every week that I come here. I don't have this one, Roland Shaw, Western Ho. Roland Shaw made some really fine Space Age records, like a couple of Spy records, which are on the top of my heap, along with some Neil Hefti albums, like the Batman. There's two Batman series. There's really fine Space Age pop, groovy 60 sound, and so Roland made a few records that are really, really great too. And I don't know what he's going to do with this Western stuff, but it'll be fun to find out. Swing is King, Ted Heath. Phase 4, Ted Heath. This has got to be a reissue, right? Is he still alive? When this record came out, was he still making music? Hit Records, it's a covers record. What do they cover on here? Oh my God. Diane. People. What I'd say. Anyway, just covers, studio covers. Nancy Wilson, Broadway My Way. It's a wonderful, wonderful cover there. Nice photograph of Nancy. Back to the Phase 4s, the romantic Rachmaninoff Camerata. See, I almost got through it. I thought I'm going to get through this one, and then I didn't. Look, the photograph on the back. There's nothing on the back but a photograph, which is kind of nice. The Kingsway Symphony Orchestra. I don't have that one. George Barnes, I have this one, but I picked it up again. Why? Because it was a dollar. And just clean as can be. Very nice. Nice cover. The Green Green Grass of Home, the Blue Ridge Quartet. I guess I picked that up because it was a dollar. It's on Canaan Records, which is a Waco, and that's more of a well-known gospel label. But it will still be nice to listen to. Power, Honey Apple, it's Poco Loco Guitars plus Brass, Love Songs South of the Border. On Knapp Records, it's the great new musical Wildcat, the Pete King Choral, and Orchestra. Ooh, there's photographs in the back of Pete King, Jack Jones, and Beth, somebody. Right there. That's a great cover, don't you think? Of course, Wildcatting is... has to do with oil, yes. I think so. The Unique Art of Andre Sigourneva. I don't even remember picking this up. What the hell? It's a guitar player, right? Yeah. You're really out there. Okay, these I picked up today. You think after all this time I would know something? I don't. Life is a Many Splendored Gig. Introducing the Herb Pomeroy Orchestra. Terrific cover on Roulette, Herb Pomeroy. I think it's jazz. Mm-hmm. Joe, five or six trumpets, three trombones, a number of five or six saxophones, a piano, bass, and drums. Right? That'll be fun. And three, Quartet Tresbiens. Kilimanjaro. God, I could pronounce that. I could even... what the hell? Left My Heart in San Francisco, Ramblin' Rose. They got bongos. They use bongos. And Boss Tresbiens, Quartet Tresbiens. There's another one there. That'll be fun. And I hope I like this group, because here's Quartet Tresbiens, exciting piano and rhythm. Spring into Spring. That's a lovely cover. Fun cover. Jazz Under the Dome, it's the Freddie Merkel group. That's interesting. Vic, Jazz Under the Dome with a big markety mark on the front. Concerto Electro, Dick Hyman Piano Concerto. This is probably going to be great. I might have to, there's big, long, movement one and movement two, just two tracks, I don't know, we'll see. I probably picked this one out, but I picked it up again. Time Machine, the Sunset, Gary Burton, Time Machine. There's a cover of Norwegian Wood, Beatles Norwegian Wood on this, so I might recover that. And here's Les Baxter I don't have. The cover's kind of dusty. It will clean up. Broadway, 61. That could be a lot of fun. Andre Previn plays Fats Wallard. Here's Andre Previn. Nice. Got this one, but I picked it up again just because it was a local lounge. And it's autographed on the back and dated December 13, 1969 by Roberto and Catiata. another phase four, Frank Shocksfield plays Ebb Tide. I don't remember ever seeing this cover. It's a two-record set. And on the inside, there's the colorful phase four catalog lineup right there. We hope that's good. We're not sure. And just, I don't know if I'll like the contents of this, but I do love the cover. Ha-cha-cha. Morton Gould, Latin American Symphonette. Henry Drome, his chorus and orchestra. Vocal Velvet. Fun cover. Andre Kostalanitz and George Gershwin. Fun, beautiful cover. And this is a nice color cover to Hawaiian Enchantment, Hawaiian Islanders. And Wine Coat, budget. Luis Bonfaz, Brazilian guitar. Oh my God, Happy Monster. Pick this up because you never know. There could be something really fun. That company made a lot of children's records. So I don't know what to expect out of that. And we're not at the end yet. Mom Goes Santa Maria, working on a groovy thing. That could be fun. What's groovy on this? The song Spinning Wheel, Proud Mary, Get Back. Might sample something for that. And the last but not least, put on the bottom of the stack because it's a wonderful cover. Space Age cover, there he is. Harold, Vic, and Combo. Harold standing in front of a rocket. An image of a rocket. All right, there we go. So check back. If you got the coronavirus, check back and let us know how it goes for you. And are you self-quarantining? So I said, well, if you self-quarantine, you come out. Like, how long is it going to last? I heard somebody say a year and a half. Well, then, shouldn't we just, like, forget trying to protect ourselves and just get it or not get it and survive or not survive? Never mind. Shut up. Turn the thing off and go pick out a musical sample. Thanks for stopping by.